Hello. Welcome back to another Sunday School Bible class. I'm so glad you're here. Today we are on a lesson entitled, The Religious Leaders Refuse to Believe Jesus. In our last lesson, we had learned how Jesus went to many towns in Israel, performing many miracles, casting out demons, and healing all types of sickness, so that his fame spread abroad to all the different countries, and many people came to Jesus. In today's lesson, we're going to find out how the evil religious leaders who were jealous of Jesus thought that they could have him killed by accusing Jesus of breaking one of the Ten Commandments. In order for us to understand how they thought that they could do this, we need to understand this one commandment that they kept accusing Jesus of breaking. One of the Ten Commandments that God gave Moses almost 2,000 years before Jesus Christ was, "Remember the Sabbath day to keep it holy." God had explained to Moses that the Sabbath day, which was the seventh day of the week, or a Saturday as we would call it today, was supposed to be a day of rest for people, and no one was supposed to go to work that day. For example, if you had a farm, you were not supposed to go in the field that day and work on the farm. If you were a fisherman, you were not supposed to go in your boat that day to try to catch fish. Or if you were a businessman or a merchant, you were not supposed to open up shop and start selling things that day. It was their day to rest, but also their day to spend time with God. The Sabbath day was supposed to be a day for all people to go to the synagogue or their temple to worship or learn about God, very similar to our Sunday when we go to church. This was called the Law of the Sabbath. Almost 2,000 years after Moses received these laws, the different groups of religious leaders called Pharisees, Sadducees, and even the chief priests and scribes added their own set of commandments to God's commandments and made the people think that their commandments were God's commandments. This was a great sin in the eyes of God because they were acting like they had the authority and the power that God has to tell people what to do. One of the most common ways these religious leaders did this was with the law of the Sabbath. The religious leaders told people that if they did the littlest thing to help someone on the Sabbath day, that they were breaking the Sabbath commandment. Jesus, being God, told the religious leaders many times that they were wrong for doing this, but they would not believe Jesus was God, even though they saw his miracles. So they were angry with him and wanted to kill him. One day, Jesus and his disciples went to Jerusalem to celebrate a holy day. In Jerusalem, there were many pools of water, but there was a special pool of water named Bethesda. Around this pool, there were many people with different types of sicknesses, infirmities, or disabilities. However, an angel went down and stirred up the water at a certain time of the year. Whoever would step into the water first after the water moved was healed of whatever infirmity or disability they had. There was a man there who was sick for 38 years. Jesus went over to the man because he knew that the man had been there for a very long time and asked the man a question. "Do you want to be cured?" The man said, "Sir, I have no man to put me in the pool when the water is troubled, and as I try to make my way into the pool, someone else gets in the pool first." Jesus then said to the man, "Rise, take up your sleeping mat and walk." Immediately the man was cured and got up, took his little sleeping mat with him, and walked away. Because this happened on the Sabbath day, the Jewish religious leaders, when they saw the man carrying his little sleeping mat, accused him of breaking the Sabbath day. When they accused him of breaking the Sabbath day, the man told them that it was Jesus, who cured him, that told him to carry his sleeping mat home. So then, the Jewish leaders went to Jesus and told him that he was breaking the Sabbath. Jesus let them know that God his Father was working miracles, as was he, making himself equal with God. So the leaders wanted to kill Jesus because not only did he break the Sabbath commandment, according to them, but that he made himself equal with God. Then Jesus departed Judea and headed north again. One day he went into a synagogue on the Sabbath day, as was the custom. In this synagogue there was a man there with a withered hand. The Pharisees watched Jesus to see if he would heal him on the Sabbath day, that they might accuse him of breaking the Sabbath day. Jesus said to the man with the withered hand, "Stand up." The man stood up in front of everyone, and while everyone looked at this man, Jesus asked the Pharisees a question. "Is it lawful to do good on the Sabbath day, or to do evil, to save life or to kill?" But they kept quiet and would not answer. Jesus looked at them with anger because he was grieved, for he knew how mean their hearts were, that they had no concern for people who were sick or injured. Then Jesus told the man with the withered hand to stretch it out, and when he did, he was healed. Instead of being glad for the man and praising God for this miracle of healing, the Pharisees were filled with anger and talked to one another about what they could do to get Jesus in trouble for this and how they could have him killed. Because they refused to believe that Jesus was God, even though they saw the evidence with their own eyes, Jesus withdrew from them, and a great multitude of people followed him, and he healed them all. One day, Jesus entered a house, and when people found out that he was in this house, they came from all over the surrounding areas, and they surrounded the house to try to see Jesus. Soon, there were so many people in and around the house that no one could even get to the door to get in the house. Among all the people who had come to the house to be healed, there was a man who was paralyzed, which means he could not walk or use his legs at all. Four of his friends carried him on a cot, which was like a little bed, and tried to bring the paralyzed man to Jesus, but they could not even get near the door, much less in the house. These men believed so strongly that Jesus could heal their friend that they climbed up the roof of the house while carrying their paralyzed friend in the cot, and then when they got on the roof of the house, they cut a hole in the roof of the house and lowered the bed that their friend was on into the house, letting the man down right in front of where Jesus was in the house. When Jesus saw their faith and determination, he told the paralyzed man that his sins were forgiven. When the religious leaders heard Jesus say that the man's sins were forgiven, they became angry because they knew only God could forgive sin. Of course, Jesus was God in human form, but they did not believe that. Then Jesus turned back to the man and said, "Arise, take up your bed and go home." Immediately, the man was healed, and he was able to get up out of bed, walk, and he went out of the house praising God in front of all the people. All the people knew that this was the same man that was paralyzed because they all saw him when his friends carried him in the bed. And they all praised God. In our upcoming lessons, we're going to see other miracles that Jesus did and how the Pharisees and other religious leaders still would not believe. See you next time. Bye-bye.